It's beekeeping time here in Anchorage, Alaska. Sitting up, making it super tight.
Yeah, good fit, but we'll put tape over this too, just to be on the safe side.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Cause why she is allergic to bees.
And I can prove it. Look!
We have an EpiPen on scene. Just in case anybody hits the ground. Get it all sealed up nice and tight.
Just do your seams here. So there's no shadow of a doubt.
Okay, so the zipper comes down, there's a little hole under the flap. Just make sure.
They can sneak in there sometimes.
No sneaking happening today.
So also you have to be careful in the end when you, yeah, we'll get you up here, but so that nobody sneaks in your pockets.
Oh, right. Yeah. Sure. Yeah.
Woman?
Woman?
Even the feet get taped up nice and tight. Now, what are you going to do if... where her socks are. I mean,
you'll see.
Okay.
Oh, you do? Right under the shoe, huh?
I normally wear boots, but I could, you know, it's too hot for boots.
Oh my. Boy, the whole foot gets taped up.
We don't.
I like this. This is safety at its finest. Now, just to mention, he will not be wearing a suit at all.
What are you doing?
We are being taped tip to toe.
We're showing you how to be safe and how not to.
Yes, exhibit A, exhibit B. Wow, nothing is left to chance. I love it. Look at that. That's a fine taping job there. Look at that.
Right. Yeah, the only problem is when I'm taped up like this, I can't operate my phone because I have no touch.
All right, I'm getting the taping.
Just to make sure they can't get up under there.
Yes, thank you. Taping on the arms there.
And then when we're all done tonight, we need to police each other real well because
these
little stinkers, they can just, they just land and they just kind of idle. And, oh, we're just hanging out.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not unusual to drag one in the car.
Oh, Lord, okay. Well, you can bet that I will do my
best to
keep them away.
No, I've never.
You probably have more mosquitoes.
Yeah.
Take a few mosquitoes in.
Yeah.
All right.
This is real. This is happening. I'm allergic to bees. I'm letting her carry my EpiPen.
Okay. I'm underneath you.
And I'm in the empty, so there you go. What do you want? Okay, put your foot up so he can tape you up.
There we go. Let's see what's going on here. They won't be all around. There'll be a few. You know, if we rock their world a little bit, they might get excited. But it shouldn't be too bad.
Yeah.
And to tell you what, I'm a little bit more of a fresh meat target for them.
I would hope so. Yeah. So, Larry, what is it that we're up to today? What's our plan?
Terry.
We have to...
Hey, Larry!
So, Terry, what are we up to tonight, Terry?
We need to do an inspection. We just need to look and see everybody's on track and what they've been doing. Are they making boys? Are they did they get real excited and make another queen? You know, if there was a queen cell, we'd knock it out. We don't need another queen right now. But so we're going to see, we're going to look at the procreation and make sure there's babies on board to be born. And see, they probably packed a little honey too, so we're just going to monitor everything they're doing and make a judgment. We're going to make a little fire here in the smoker. right now.
Where are they at in their process? Are they about halfway done with?
No, they're just starting.
Oh, okay.
Right now, they're out there looking in the environment, making a plan, making boys, thinking about splitting the hive, making a queen. The actual honey flow, the nectar flow, doesn't start until about the second week of July. So the way things have, for me, that work, if there's any honey in the hive before July, I'll take it out. Whatever you take out, they'll put back. But from this point to the first week of July, you might have a little bit of a blend where you'd have a little bit of sugar water honey, maybe some stuff they found in a pop can, but not real nice nectar honey. So.
Okay.
So I'm going to make a little fire here with some.
And what does the smoke do? What's the purpose of that?
Smoke kind of disguises what's going on. It dulls their senses. It does a couple of things. The bees go, ah, fire, let's go out of here. Some leave.
Oh, okay.
Other bees will say, fire, my God, we got to leave. But before we go, we'll fuel up.
Hmm.
And they'll burrow down and get some honey.
Mm-hmm.
And other ones will just fly around like, what do we do? So,
like some men in life that are confused.
What are we supposed to, like George Costanza. Fire!
And so what's that you're putting in there? Maybe a little propane or something?
No, a little bit of oil.
Oil, okay.
A sock, some cardboard, and some lighter fluid. And we'll let that stoke a bit. And you want a cool, soft smoke. Nothing too hot. Something that's going to smolder.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll see how I roll the smoke on the business. So, and then we have this. Linda, I'll assign it to you. That is the grab.
Right, what about the other?
Yeah, and the other super tool. Yeah, you got that. There's some hive tools that we'll use.
What are those?
You'll see. Yeah, these grab the racks, but this kind of loosens the racks.
Do a little demo here.
Okay. When these are full of bees and honey, they kind of get sticky.
Oh, they
stick
are
to each
so
other,
sticky.
So you have to separate them. So so it's a case on the other end.
Yeah.
It's a case of kind of loosening them either end, and then you would get this in and lift it up.
Oh, interesting. Look at that.
What we usually do when we break into a hive, we'll take an end slat out somehow, this way, that way. We'll take this out and just put it off to the side so that when we work with these slats, we have enough room, we can pull it back. As we pull them up, there'll be bees on both sides, and you don't want to just try to, you know, bump them and brush them. You want to be as ginger and tender as you can.
Mm-hmm.
So there's usually 10 on the top. There's 10 slat hives, 8 slat hives. Everything I have here is 10 slat.
So. And you're going to be looking for the queen also.
The queen. She has a decorated dot on her back. So it's a blue dot this year for 2020. So it'll be a, I'm sure we'll see one. And you go, oh, well, look at that. And when you see the queen, you'll see the difference in the body. She has a little bit bigger banaka donka, little bit bigger back section. So.
Interesting. All right.
Her whole purpose in life is to have sex and have babies.
Is that what she does?
She lives for 5 years just to lay eggs. And
was he just bumping
the,
a little bit?
The other girls will make the cell work, and the eggs that she fertilizes will become girls. The ones that she doesn't fertilize will become boys.
Oh.
They've just started building these on this
that
framework.
Wow, that's incredible. Look at that.
So if you feel uncomfortable, just say so. We'll just stop and back away from everything.
I will. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. The purple box is a very active hive. These are the marines. The other boxes are just regular. Get this. This is old sugar water feeder. When we get started, we'll start with the pineapple hive there. When I mean the pineapple hive, the bottom box has got pineapples painted on it.
Oh, okay.
There's a mosquito. You don't feel that in your teeth.
We got condos here. Now, I'm going to stand back and let him show you. Do you want me to film you?
Sure.
Okay, see the smoke?
Well, here's this tree, a lilac bush and an apple tree. So you're going to open this up.
God, look at them all. Okay, relax.
Hi, guys.
Now go
relax.
Film.
Just relax.
And we're going to roll a little smoke over the top of them. Cool smoke. I don't power them too much, just let it roll. And I'm going to put a little in the entrance. You notice they've gone down since I rolled the smoke. Kind of dries them down a little bit. I'm going to start with my end cut. See how everything's stuck together. And there's usually not too much going on here. They're just kind of cruising. So we're going to put this one, put it down here. It'll be fine. Then I take my tool, and I kind of snap it like this. Bring this up.
Ooh,
and I feel some weight.
Wow.
And if you look at the glisten here, that's honey. That's nectar honey that hasn't been capped yet. This is some nonsense that somebody shouldn't have built. And then here we have capped honey. This is all capped. And there's a boy. Boys don't sting. He's this big fatty. And the girls are a little bit smaller.
Yeah.
Then what we do is we go through every slat on the top, and then we take the top off and go through every slat on the bottom.
There's more.
Now, here we have a good. A lot of things going on here. We got honey, a fingerling of honey, the flat, procreation, these are the girls. The bumpy, the ones that's sticking up, those are the boys. Those are boys to be born. Well, not so much anymore. Dr. Holtman is going to take care of that. Usually just take and schwack them off. But there should be a half rack in here too. So we don't need those guys.
Any?
And same on the other side. No queen yet.
Okay.
She's probably in the bottom somewhere.
Look at all those bees.
Oh, boy.
Now, look at how much Terry's getting stung. None.
How about Larry? Is Larry getting stung?
Well, Larry might get stung if we find that son of a gun. So we got to break this up. Everything's stuck together. So it's a little bit of a work, you know. This is going to take a little bit of time because we got two boxes, three boxes, four boxes. Five. Hey, Dale.
Hi.
How are you? You're looking good. What do you think? These girls been busy on your, all right.
I think we're going to get lots of apples this year.
All right, so, same thing. Look at all this nice procreation. The flat, these are the boys. Now here's one stinging me now. She just stung me.
Really?
Yeah, see the little tailing there? It's coming out of her butt, she can't get away. There it goes.
Oh my God.
Hey, stop it now. All right, I need a little smoke. Okay, deal.
That's what the brush, sorry.
No, that's okay. That's all right. Save it. Save him.
No biggie.
That didn't hurt?
Not really. It's like a mosquito bite.
Hurt.
Not
really?
Me. Well,
maybe it hurts Larry.
Bees only hurt Larry.
Yeah. So, we'll get these boys out of here.
You know what? You've just given me an out. You don't realize that yet, but you have.
Oh, yeah?
If I inadvertently call him Larry.
There you go. Everybody does it all the time.
That was my
then you're safe.
Name.
Oh, my God! Of all the names I could have picked. Well, I was pretty close, though, wasn't I? Oh, jeez.
No queen yet. Same
no queen.
Deal. Boy, I tell you.
Way, way back.
We're going to find the half rack. That half rack has got to be full. And because it's full, they've been putting bees, the other boys, someplace else.
Look at that.
Tell you what, they've been busy.
You okay?
All good.
See how they immediately go down when you smoke them?
Yeah. There's a bee on me. Look at this. Oh, he's gone.
Yeah. So this is good looking. Look at, we're going to have a population explosion. There's hundreds of girls that are to be born there in that dark brown.
Now, can any of the girls become queen?
No, they have to make a queen cell. That's done with royal jelly. That's another story. You are just a sponge for information. That's good.
Well, I am quite terrified of bees.
Oh. Well, you shouldn't. They are our sisters.
They become more fascinating. The fascination takes over from the terror.
So there's a little bit of honey here. Oh, here we got some stinging going on.
Oh, geez, oh God.
We just got to smoke them a little bit.
Yeah, you should have bought your black suit.
Well, you know.
Do you need me to do
Do you need me to do anything?
I'm good. Here, you pump that a little bit, would you? So, yeah, procreation, honey. A lot of honey.
No queen.
Not yet. That's right. We won't find a half rack up here. We'll only find it in the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Right? Are you doing okay, Linda?
I'm doing okay, yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Yep. You can just hear them buzzing all around.
Oh, yeah.
Business
oh
here.
My goodness, yeah, look
a little
at that.
Rocks. Mm-hmm. See now,
no.
As long as they're smoked a little bit, they're going to make honey. See the glisten? That's nectar honey in there, and they're going to cap that in time. It's pretty early yet, but this is a line side box. If you look up, there's the highlight. So, let me get these.
Meaning that they're beneath the power lines,
right.
Is what you said, right?
Yeah.
And the power lines does what again?
Agitates them a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like, did you want me to shake my wife again like I did in the car? We're going to wrap this box up and look at it.
Now, when you pull the honey from these things, what then do you do with it?
Well, we extract it. Well, there's a whole process to extraction. You have to decap the slats, put a slat in a centrifuge, spin it, comes out into a filtering bucket, and you jar it up, and that's that.
You'll have to come back a couple of times
to
see
the
whole process through.
Okay.
The whole shooting match.
and he does not sell his honey, by the way.
Oh.
We're going to see what's going on in the wolf box.
The wolf den.
Oh, we're crowded.
They must have good eatings over there at the.
Well, usually it's a twofer sign that sometimes there's a lot of population in there. Everybody's got to come up here because it's too warm in here. So.
Is the sting from these sorts of bees the same as you would get from, I don't know, maybe a wasp or something, or are they different?
A little different.
I have been stung, and it's. Oh, did I just get stung?
Oh, really?
Oh, and then you have to look. Oh, yeah, I got stung.
So we got some issues here.
We do.
We have bee comb that's attached to the top of the slats. So when I'm trying to get this topper off, I'm pulling up slats at the same time.
Oh,
oh look at
oh
that.
Oh, my God.
Look at that.
Okay.
Look at that.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, look at that honey.
Wow.
It's all honey, yeah. See, they needed a topper. I got the topper.
Still no queen, huh?
Wow, look at that. Look at that.
Look. Is that glistening?
There's honey right there. Yeah. Girls?
That's amazing. Look at that.
Yeah, see, they usually park their honey in the top of the hive. A bad beekeeper didn't have his topper up here on time, but he brought one along tonight.
Oh, boys, too.
Yeah, boys and honey.
Oh man, this is unreal.
See the larvae? Those are the boys.
That sounds gorgeous.
chew on that once the bees are coming through.
Really?
Oh yeah, it's good.
Oh my god, wow. That's amazing.
This is why we inspect, so these things don't happen so much. But some of this is boy procreation, some of it was honey, but they tied it into the into what that piece of wood called the bee escape.
Called the what?
It's called the bee escape.
Bee escape.
It's just that little board with a hole in it.
Wow. Oh my god, look at them all over me.
You did a lot of work.
God, I can't believe you are standing there with nothing on.
I have clothes on, unless you've seen me in some other light.
Well, that boxing match was a bit revealing.
Oh,
oh no.
Dinner now.
Gosh, she's getting stung.
You all right?
Let me.
Well, that way, Sal.
A dead one here. It should be a blank cell, a blank slot.
Terry, do you think they know you after time?
Well, they say that bees can do face recognition. Oh. I don't know. If that's so, I'm going to snap this, and they're going to get a little excited. Oh, here, this, when they do that like this, this is called festooning, the way they tie themselves together. A new word for the day, festooning.
That is a new word.
Can you hang on? Can you hand me a half rock over there, Linda Holtman?
Take a step back so I can
hold on to
get
that.
A whole view of this.
Now the key is not to panic.
Are you panicking, Linda? Are you okay?
I'm okay, because they can't get to me. They can't get to you.
Yeah. I'm
go.
Panicked for him.
We're going to put a half rack in.
Okay.
Don't bother.
We're going to hang on to that. And we're going to grab that other box, Linda. Here, give me this. Grab that brown box.
Man, look at the bees.
Got it. Check them all down here, Lee.
Oh, wow, look at that.
So we put a half rack, we put a topper. We just got to scrape that crap off there. And that's how we service this. So hang on, we're going to give it a little snap.
Can't.
Well, yes, I can.
Well, do you have another top?
No, we'll do something different.
You don't have another bee escape?
But this is amazing. This is.
Did you just put that in your mouth?
This is honeycomb.
This honeycomb was honey.
Oh, we can't do that. I forgot.
Could you fit it through the netting?
Okay, keep with us. We'll come back on the top.
Wow, that's really impressive.
We're gonna just pull off the grid there. For right now. Silly girl.
Where's the brush?
You alright?
Yeah, it's the ground's uneven.
You're eating the honey.
That's right.
The honey is eating the honey. Look at that. Wow. They say it's really good for your immune system, right?
Everything is. Oh, well, yeah.
And I think somebody had told me when I was in Oregon that within 25 miles of where you live, it's best to get the honey from those bees.
Yeah, it helps with allergies because it's got all the local fauna has been made to make that honey, collected to make that honey. Look at it, I can't get over that. Look at that lot.
Let me go see over here what she's talking about. Watch, don't trip over that, Linda, right behind you. Wow.
Yeah, they're checking shit out. That's right. Linda Holtman, can you hand me the smoker?
I never get called by one name, by the way.
You always have a couple.
No half rack. There's a half rack in here.
Oh.
But that's in the bottom.
Oh.
I forgot to put the tenth tray in.
Oh, okay.
So there we go. We're gonna go in the big purple box. Hopefully
big
find
boy.
The queen.
The big boy. Whatever.
So, I probably got stung about 5 times so far. Not too bad.
Out here today, 5 times, huh?
Yeah, that's not bad.
Not
it's not like
you
a 30 or 40 night. That happens.
Yeah. He's afraid. I got to get it on film.
Service a box. Always best to stand on the side. Are you ladies? Alright, so we're gonna do a little smoky smoky. Artichoke.
We need to find a queen.
Well, we need to do a lot of things. Let's get you off to the side a little bit.
Yeah,
there we go.
Wow, that's amazing. And that just what? It like makes them high for a minute, huh? Or
no,
relaxes them?
They kind of go into, what the hell is this? Let's regroup and figure out what we need to do. And that's why some, see how sticky everything is? Some go and will fly off. Some will eat the honey. This baby's loaded.
Yeah? Is it heavy?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh my.
Some work to be done here. All these darn boys.
Wow.
Anyways, we're gonna put this down. We're gonna apply a little smoke. Okay, it's getting a little wild. And I'm standing in front of somebody's entrance, okay? So they don't like that either. Creation. A lot of stuff going on.
Wow.
So will the queen be upstairs? Okay, yeah, there's a lot down the bottom, boys.
Yeah. That's what, probably because the other half right is full. I'm not seeing the queen yet. She's around. Because bushes. You're looking at all the procreation that's been handled here, handed out.
You all right, baby?
I'm doing okay. These girls are feisty, which is good.
Well, they're under paralyzed.
Yeah?
How many times do you think he got stuck now, Terry?
Six.
Six? Man, I just would not be okay. I haven't been stung.
Oh, wait a minute. Is that the queen?
Do you see a dot?
Is that a... Oh, no, it's a boy.
Okay. Yeah, the boy's a little bigger. I'll tell you what. Can it, because they're pretty active here. But this will give you an idea, and when I can suit up a little bit better, we'll do a little bit more, but you're getting a pretty good idea what's going on.
Yeah. We've got another layer down
My
here
God.
To go through.
A lot of procreation, a lot of boys being born, so it's important to go through every slat at some time to make sure there's no queen cell.
There's no queen what?
Cell, like they're going to make another queen.
If they do, then half the hive are going to leave with her when she takes off.
Oh, wow.
You don't want to lose your hive.
Hmm.
Well, you know, it's kind of a...
Incredible.
How many times you get stung, Lee, Linda?
Zero.
None.
Zero.
Good for you.
And Linda got stung. Zero.
Yeah, I'm not into being stung.
That's good procreation there.
Yeah, no kidding. Wow.
Pretty nice.
What's
and
that,
even.
That big one at the bottom? That's not queen,
no,
is it?
No. It would look like a peanut. Like
okay.
A planter's peanut.
Get rid of all this on the top?
Sure. Just a little scraping. So this is the kind of girl that would probably just walk with you and
hang out with you.
And then sting her.
A lot of people are going to comment that you're standing amongst bees with no suit on. What's your educational?
Say again?
What's your educational spew there? People will be saying he's standing there. He doesn't have a bee suit on.
They're going to think you're a moron and no education. You got to explain that.
Yeah.
What I do. I know when to put a suit on and when not to.
Yeah. So do you? Yeah. It's
not too intense right now.
Yeah.
It's semi-intense, but not too bad. Like, they'll come and check me out. Maybe I get a sting in like that. But if I roll enough smoke, we'll be okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so your thing is if you get stung so many times because then you feel like they're agitated or whatever, then you put a suit on.
Back on.
Yeah, got it. Okay.
Can you see in here?
Oh,
where you
wow.
get to look in the hive.
Oh, wow.
We can revisit this weekend if you want.
Wow, this is really incredible.
And,
this is probably one of the neatest things I've done in Alaska.
Well, there you go.
Who would have dreamt?
You
bees.
You can follow this through, too, for the end of the year.
Yeah.
See the honey and...
Oh, wow. Oh, that would be so cool.
Yeah. Well, you live here, we live here,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You just let us know when you want to come.
That'd be cool.
Police each other when we get there.
Man, they make so much noise.
On the way out, okay, let me brush her off.
Pure, this is
well, that's
pure
honeycomb,
honey.
But it's
honey, look at that.
Wow. Okay, come on.
He's
Yeah, I'm trying to get the bee off of it. That's okay.
There's one right there on the ground.
I got it.
Get
yeah. Oh, there's another one.
It's all right. Fly girl.
About the other side.
This one? We'll scoot this up and put it in a jar.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. Honey in it. And if food was short, they can, you know, they've got that for sure then, but. Oh, girl. And boy.
Oh, look at there.
That's not his honey, though, but.
No, well, it's somebody's honey. No. But it's comb honey.
It's just like what this is, though, huh?
Uh-huh.
It is. Huh. But it's not, this is fresh.
Golly.
You notice the more you chew it, the harder it gets.
Uh-huh, yeah.
So you just spread it out. Or you can collect it in there, Mr.
Holtman. Yeah, and the other thing you can do is if you don't want to deal with the wax, you can just invert this and let gravity do its job. And all
oh,
that.
Really? And the...
It just the honey will drip.
Just turn it
is
upside
that right?
down.
Yeah.
God, look at that dripping. Look at that.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Look at that. You said a teaspoon a day, huh?
It yep. helps keep the allergies intact, yeah.
Wow. Look at that. Look at that.
You want to try?
That's just the honey there.
Pure
just,
honey, huh?
Yep. Yep.
Look at that. Yep.
Okay, now you got to eat that now.
Wow. Oh, my God. Wow.
How about that? Not like store-bought, is it?